Hello, universe, once again. Spaceboot1 with you once again. Playing, what game are we playing? This time we're playing some more Millénaire. I think this is episode 5 now that we're on. Episode 5 of Millénaire. And as you can see, we have our little self-contained paddock. This isn't going to protect us too much against zombies or anything like that, but it is kind of a demarcation of sort of, I guess, where I belong and such things. Spaceboot One's camp. And yeah, like I was saying, I don't know if I'm going to improve it or not. In the meantime, let's do some wood chopping, just to get things started. I guess that's my job for now. I'm a wood chopper. Actually, I was thinking, basically my plans for today we are going to... Ooh, look, an apple. Good. Good, good. I should get some... Yeah, it shouldn't be hard for me to find some leather, find some cows and make a saddle to saddle up one of these horses. But I suppose... I don't think they're in danger of despawning, so maybe I can just, you know, let them be wild and free for the time being. And... Ooh, look at all that wood. Okay. And we'll... I suppose we'll hang on to it as oak wood, because they're probably going to need some more of this style of wood. Okay, and now that some of these saplings have dropped, we can start replanting these. Replant. Okay, so yes, we are, in case you missed the first couple episodes, we are playing Minecraft with the Millénaire mod. That's the, it adds villages like this one over here. Let's go visit them. Let's go say hi. Oh, I think I see a new kid. Two new kids. Because this one's different. Oh yeah, I remember this one. This is Frida. And this is Giselda. And this is that Erwin, the other kid? Erwin Sigvald. And Giselda and Erwin are brother and sister. And the population is 12. Oh, did somebody die? Okay. Cool. Well, yes. Hello, hello. Hello, Mr. Guildmaster. Norbert Waldemar. Waldemar. I'll try and remember that, the guildmaster. And let's see what's going on over here. Oh, the miner. He's actually finally digging a bit of a hole here, so we'll see. Something cool might happen there. Let's go back here for just a second, because the last time I was here, they needed cobblestone. They have all the glass they need. Oh, they also need iron ingots. They have a person working on cobblestone, so this is going to get filled sort of automatically. But I don't know if they have anybody working on iron ingots. And I think that's something I could probably help them out with. So I was thinking what I might do for this episode, I might be like a super miner and really do some deep mining. Probably not all the way to like diamonds quite yet, although, hey, maybe this could be our diamond episode. This whole series, though, is not necessarily about collecting diamonds and things, so I may not ever need diamonds or redstone in this particular video series. Oh, I thought... Do you see that there's some long grass up there? I thought that was a creeper. Well, you can never be too careful. Okay, did I replant all these? Oh, here's one more. And another one grew, but I think we have enough wood for the time being. Do we? Yeah, we don't need it. Okay. Yeah, we're good. I could probably also start farming those, what are those, spruce trees? I could farm the spruce trees too. So, yeah, let's sort of arrange things. We'll leave the wood there for now. Actually, I like having the apple with me as an extra bit of food. Okay, so what do I need to bring with me into a cave? I guess not really much. Basically, I think I'm gonna go northwest-ish. Just see what we see. Oh, look at this. This is actually kind of perfect. Oop. Get a little bit of lag. Careful. I'm sorry if, I know my video kind of, it jumps around a little bit, and, that's probably not the most pleasant thing for you, the viewer, because I realize that, that it might think, make you think that, maybe it's your system that's sort of glitching out or whatever, and you might panic a little bit. So I do apologize for that. Just want to let you know that that is gonna happen with my videos, is that every once in a while my computer is gonna freeze up a little bit. So if that happens, I don't want you to panic. I want you to just think that it's probably not your computer, it's probably mine that's doing the bad stuff. On the other hand, maybe it is your computer, but yeah. So I will use this. Here, let's put some torches at the entrance. And let's just see what happens if we go down here. I guess we'll make a little makeshift stairs. Which way should I go? Using up all my dirt. Actually, I don't know if this is gonna work out too well. Well, there goes my dirt. I can always get more dirt, but well, this was cool, but yeah. I believe I have discovered. Oh, wait. Aha, here we go. Okay. We're gonna do some iron mining. Cool. I guess I should look both ways. Look both ways before you dig. Ah, got it. Okay. This looks like a dead end, so we'll just do that. Yoink. Yoink. And we'll just do some mining. Delicious coal. Delicious coal? I always say that, don't I? I've said that before in my videos. I need to think of another way to express my happiness when I find something good to mine. I always worry that, I am definitely having a lot of fun when I play these games, but I do worry that, sort of, I don't know if my enthusiasm always shows through, because I sort of always keep cool, and it's like, oh, there's a creeper, and stuff like that, but okay, actually, so, it looks like we have discovered the extent, the final extent of this particular mine, or this cave, anyways, I believe. So, the question is, can we go further? Should we go further? Well, I think I do want to find more places to mine, because that's what we need to do. We need to be a miner. Maybe I should find a nice dirt pocket and grab some more dirt, just so I have it. This looks like a promising pocket. And maybe, you never know, it might open up into a cave somewhere. Also, this is why diamond would probably come in handy, is because it's slightly faster, and my shovel is going to wear out really quickly. It's green right now, but it's definitely, if I do keep on doing this, then it won't last very long. And if I had diamond, it would last quite a bit longer. Lots of dirt. Cool. Hopefully this doesn't break out into sand. Yeah, it's probably going to. I should stop about there-ish. Because that's. Oh! There we go. Let's get that dirt on the hotbar. Okay, so yes. Oops. Let's place it back, sort of. And we'll make that the end of the cave. Cool. I suppose I'll place one down here. Now, it is night out there. If these were sort of the, or it's not quite night, it's just getting a bit dark. Stars are coming out. If this were vanilla Minecraft, I would be worried for the villagers, because I think zombies would attack them. I don't want you going in there, horse. I don't think he can fit in there now, so. But yeah, I don't think the zombies actually attack the Millénaire villagers. I could be wrong about that, though, so. I don't know. The thing about Millénaire, the other thing about Millénaire, is the villagers reproduce at night. Like, I guess they make babies or whatever at night. When I first started playing Millénaire, this may have changed actually, I haven't checked the latest version, but when I first started playing Millénaire, I kept on sleeping through the nights in a bed, and my villages never grew, and I couldn't figure out why, and then I figured out, I think I looked it up on some wiki or something, so it wasn't that big a deal, but yes, I learned something that day. So, yeah, I guess I'm just looking for more caves. Ooh, I hear weasels. Oh, gotta be careful. Here's a zombie. Gonna get you, zombie. Gonna get you. Did he drop a good anything? Gold armor isn't really that good anyways. I'm gonna swim across here. Because I thought I saw a ravine over here. Let's just have a look. It's very pretty, Minecraft. Yeah, you saw me. Gotcha. Ooh, lights. I think that's lava. Cool. Okay. Oops, here we go. This is what I'm talking about. I like how there's a lake on, because I think the ravine goes, oh, it doesn't. That's interesting. Let me just have a look at this again. It's a very flat wall. Feels like it might even be a chunk border, but no, I don't think so. I think it just naturally spawned that way. That's interesting. I like it, though. Him. So there's like a natural little bridge with even a little pool of water in the middle. That's really cool. I guess it's that would be what it was. It's because this is a river and it intersects with the ravine. So the river overwrites the ravine. That's why it's weird like that. Do you get it? The river's coming from that direction and it's kind of like windy, wobbly through here. And of course it's not completely filled in, but yeah, it passes right through here. Yeah, right through the ravine. Okay, so I want to actually find a way down into this, because I'm thinking I might sort of head to that other end there, and sort of make my way across. I don't know if I have enough dirt to bridge all that way. Oh, interesting, that water's just floating there. Probably should get rid of that or something. Let's see, how do I want to get down in there? This is a little bit dangerous, I think. Danger, that's my middle name. Oh, careful. Can I place... I guess I'll just kind of do this. Make my way across here. What do I want to do with this lava? I think maybe I'll just sort of go around it. Kind of. Ooh, what do I see down there? Is that sand at the very bottom? That's interesting, because I've never seen sand spawn so low, but I guess it's part of the river, or something, who knows. Ooh, here, okay, here's something cool. Another cave. Okay, let's light this up a little bit. It's just a short little cave. I kind of like short little caves with sort of definite endings. Something satisfying about, like, yep, that's finished. I almost want to, although, yeah, continues over this direction. Is grass gonna grow? Yeah, in theory, grass. Well, just for fun. What if I did that? Now, yeah, and maybe this. Oops, not that. What are you doing? Now grass can grow all the way along here. That'd be kind of neat. Maybe I should actually fill it in, because it is a bit dangerous. And we'll do a torch there. And here we have something else. I see, this looks like daylight coming in this cave, so let's have a look. Oh, look who's in there. Two creepers. I don't think they can, they don't have a path to me, though. It's like, oh, let's check, there's nothing at the end of this here. Oh, I see, that's where the daylight was coming from, right there. Interesting, okay, so I don't think the creepers can get out from there. I wonder if I should... I like this little lookout hole. Kind of fun. I guess I'll just leave it. I was thinking of covering it up, but why would I do that? Okay, let's go venture in here. And we're killing the creepers, killing them. Little audio interruption here. My recording stopped recording at this moment. My audio stopped, so I'm just recording it in the future. So I'm just watching myself replay this footage back again. Yeah, just walking through the cave. Let's see if I remember what I was doing. More of this dirt filling in with the dirt. Making a path all the way to the end, and I want to start at the far end of this cave and sort of work my way back and get all the resources as we go down the line. Got to get it lit up nicely with a torch, and we're building a nice smooth 45 degree staircase past the lava. That's a little bit dangerous, but I think we're going to be okay. I haven't died yet in this, but yeah, that's, we've got only about 45 minutes of play so far in this world, so a lot of stuff can still happen. I am planning on taking you through, like, recording a lot of what I play in this particular world. I don't know how often I'm actually going to get to it. It might be just a once in a while thing, but I think this, for this particular series, I think I'm going to try and record as much of it as possible. And if there are boring parts like caving and stuff, I'm just going to try and do commentary. And here I've decided that I don't have enough dirt. I'm basically using dirt as my construction material down here, as my scaffolding and pillars and stairways and everything like that. So, and then for some reason I want to fill in this underneath the stairs, just so it feels more substantial, feels more like a, I don't know. Doesn't need to be like that at all. And we'll just grab this coal. Coal mining. The funnest thing to do in Minecraft. And yeah, I'm assessing about how to get that iron and also what to do about this this lava. I like to do that. Well, you can see on the screen, that's what I like to do with lava, is I like to make a little hole for it to fall in, and then otherwise just kind of leave the lava column like that. That's sort of, and that's my current approach to lava anyways. Oh, I think that, I think I lost a piece of iron there. That was upsetting. Yeah, nice little receptacle for the lava to flow into, so that's fun. Oh yeah, we want that. We want to get every resource out of here that we can, because we're currently, you know, at a point in the world where we can pretty much use everything we can find. So we're going to grab this coal. And, you know, never know, there might be some iron hiding behind it too. I guess I know I'm in the future, so I know if that's going to happen or not. I actually can't remember if I found iron here. Nope. And then I'm back, sort of standing at the level of the, whatchamacallit, the dirt floor, I guess, that's going to be above. But yeah, I don't want to mess around with that quite yet again. Although I do, I think I want to fill that all in and just basically make it a floor. But yeah, we'll continue on getting some iron. Not sure what my count is at right now. I probably should have just put it on my bar so I could count it as I go, but I think I have plenty. I think I'm at what the village needs right now, but I'm thinking I want a bit of extra iron for myself, for my own projects, and to make tools and stuff, because as you can see, some of my tools are a little bit worn down. And yeah, we're going to catch. See, notice I like to catch water in dirt, and I like to catch lava in cobblestone. It's not really a necessary thing to do, but it's just some. For some reason, I like doing that. And we're back to playing in real time in 2 seconds. And yeah, we need to really, really replace this, I guess. Can I use sand? I guess I can turn sand into glass, because they will need glass for some village projects, so I guess we can work on that. Actually, yeah, this sand is nice for river sand. I guess it's river sand or lake sand or whatever, you know what I mean? It's nice in that respect, though, because I don't actually have to dig underwater for it. Okay, so I have probably enough dirt, I think. Could use a little bit more iron, though, to be honest. And I'm going to do something with this. I'm going to do that, 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 and that. And we'll get rid of this and this. Careful not to burn myself. And I am going to do something about this floating water. I guess I don't. And if we go here, is that going to get rid of it? One more. I feel like I've ruined, like, something special, but I think it's alright. Oh, did it hit the lava? No, I don't think it did. Eh, we might have some extra cobblestone down here. Oh, there goes my shovel. How much iron did I get? Not very much. 23. I bet I washed away some torches. Let me just check down here. This looks okay. I don't think I need that. Okay, well, this looks. Oh, let's get that coal. I think that's basically going to tap out this ravine. Oh, there's another half, right? I wonder if I should just dig right through or go up and above. I think I might have to save the other half for later, though. And for now, I may just bring back this particular little set of iron back to the village. I guess I'll bring it back to my camp and cook it. I think that's the best thing to do. Let's see, from here, if I go up here like this, Yeah, I kind of wanted to do a whole bunch of grass in here, or dirt in here, and have grass like grow all over it. But I think I'm gonna leave it just for the for now. And yeah, there's definitely more iron and stuff in there. Ooh. Let's go down there. Let's do this the this way. Sploosh. Oh, I think I. Yeah. I don't know if that was the best way to get down, but there's just so much more iron in here. I really need it. I need it so bad. I need iron. I'm like addicted to iron. I'm definitely addicted to Minecraft. There's no arguing that. The question is, what elements within Minecraft am I most addicted to? Probably iron. Iron and coal. Although I'm skipping the coal. Okay, let's just continue along the floor for the for a little bit. Here. Get this. Oh, do I see a skeleton? Oh, I see a couple. I wonder if there's a spawner back there. Probably not. How should I do this? Boink. And then I want to do a stairway up to here. Okay, yeah, that's a dead end. We can do another stairs. I'm not sure how I should get work on this. Oh. Get him. Got him. Okay. Yeah, good thing I didn't leave any lava down there or anything like that. Okay, hopefully that was the last skeleton up there. Oh, I hear another skeleton. There might be a spawner. That'd be kind of cool. And, well, it's definitely dark, and it's definitely another skeleton. But I think I've discovered the end of this cave. And there's coal, and I want this coal, but I think for now I'm just gonna have to leave it because there are other priorities right now. How do I get across? So yeah, I've got all the iron down low. So let's just do a bridge across here. Bridge, bridge. Bridge, bridge, bridge. And we'll light it up. Even though technically it's pretty light out here already, so it's not like we're doing too badly. I'm gonna need a new pick probably before I get all this iron. I'm gonna do something with the bottom of this. There. Now I have a stair at this end, so this makes it easy so I don't have to be pillaring and stuff. Oops, unless I. Nope, this works. Yep, we do that. And then we have to. I didn't think about this. We have to get around this water without. I mean, I suppose I could just break the water. Sometimes I do. Like, I remember when I first started playing my main single player world, I was very careful not to destroy like water sources and stuff, and then that kind of went out the window later on. It's like I just kind of got used to playing the same way that everybody plays, and that you just sort of wreck the world and take what you need, which is yeah. I guess I learned that lesson because my world is very big, and if I destroy like a little piece of it, like as one person in a single player world, there's no way I could ever damage a world so that it was like ecologically broken or anything like that. So I'm gonna just pillar out here. I think having my pick broken is probably a good excuse to head home. Yes, hello, Mr. Weasel. Oh, there's another cave up there. Well, I don't know. There might not be iron in there. But let me see. What do I? Oh, I have 61 iron. That was actually, yeah, that was probably a really good idea what I did there. Heading into the heading into the second ravine there, because I really needed that. I needed that gold. So the next thing I want to do is head back to camp, base camp, I guess is what is it, what it's called, near Sainte Marie, where I am a known face. And I have not killed any chickens. Or have I? I don't know. I don't think I killed any chickens in the town. I definitely killed chickens earlier in this series. Okay, let's go around here. And I'm not actually gonna go to sleep. I am gonna do a second one of these guys. Because we need to do quite a bit of cooking. Oh, look, I got a couple of bows here. I'm just gonna put that away. What else can I put away? All this junk. Oh, I never ate those apples. I guess that's fine. How are we doing for cobble? Yeah, the town may need some more cobble, but I think I'm just gonna hang on to it for now. I have enough iron that I can make a new pickaxe, so I'll do that. I should probably make a new iron axe too, but maybe not quite yet. I need some more torches. There, good. Oh, all my trees grew too. That's great. You know, they sure grow fast. I think they did grow rather quickly. Kind of looking over the village. I should build like a little platform or a watchtower. Maybe I should just let's do that. Let's since it is night. Let's climb up this hill and get a nice little view of the town. There, I should light up. These caves are like a place that, you know, like a little hermit could live in or something. Or maybe that's me. Maybe I'm the hermit. I don't know. Oh my. It's a zombie party. I'd rather not let the creeper explode. Yes. Okay, good work. I don't know why all these zombies spawned in here. I guess it's just a spot to spawn. Let me see. How can I do that? I like this. I can get a little kind of lookout here. As long as there's no skeletons around to knock me over. That's kind of cool. But what I wanted to do was I didn't come up here for the cave, although that's really cool. You have a little, like a hermit could live in this cave. But yeah, I wanted to climb to the top of the mountain. Well, not the entire mountain, but yeah, no, I mean, I guess, I mean, the thing is, it's not that big of a mountain. There's bigger mountains over there. But I have this mountain here where I kind of overlook the village and see what I see. See, there's the guild house in the middle. It's pretty cool. I can't remember what this building is here. Behind it is the mine. I should keep a watch my back just in case there might be skeletons wanting to shoot me off here. Maybe I should build like a little fence up here or something like that. We have some fenced in like tree chopping areas over there. I can't remember what that one is either. I can't remember what all these buildings are. But yeah, it's definitely a cool little village. You know, it's sort of starting out, just gonna, yeah, just kind of. I like how it's half in the forest too. That's kind of cool. And can you see in the distance there? Can you see that tree that's like sort of half gone? They do that when they spawn. They sort of automatically delete certain parts of trees, and then they leave like weird cut off trees and bits. But I may end up If I feel like it, I might clean that up. That might be a project to do, to clean up a little edges. And maybe, like, it's usually what people do with villages is they don't like to have the forest too close to a village, because, you know, monsters can. I mean, obviously these guys, for some reason, I need to think of a lore reason why they're not afraid of monsters. But yeah, for some reason, they're not too worried about the monsters. But yeah, normally what you'd do with a village is you would kind of clear the trees away in sort of a radius of it. And that's just a horse, that's fine. Yeah, so to keep like animals from hiding in the forest or whatever. Of course, in modern times, like in the city that I live in, people they love their trees, and there are trees like everywhere. But of course, if trees get too big, they get in the way, and people have to cut them down because you don't want a tree like knocking your house over or something like that. I'm gonna take his bone. Yes, but yeah, I think what I'm gonna do with this one is sort of remove some of those outside trees. And we have lots of iron now. Okay, that's excellent. And let's drop some of this stuff. Do we need to make a fishing rod? Kind of want to have one, but yeah, I'll make it. I don't know if I'll actually use it, but it's good to have, right? Oh, I could even do a carrot on a fishing rod. But yeah, I don't need to make that right now. Okay, so as soon as morning comes around, it's pretty much morning. We're gonna go into town. Should I bring the wood with me too? I'm gonna bring everything I can possibly trade. So this, yeah, I will bring this extra cobblestone. I don't want to trade like my bread though, because I may want to eat that. Oh, I think I'll make this. I'll just pop this in the furnace to cook and make that into glass, because they may want that. But yeah, that's about. I think that's everything I want for now, for the time being. Is that a phrase I'm overusing? I think I am. I gotta watch that. Okay, sun is coming up. We're heading into the village to trade. Oh, and on the way, we might have a little bit of a fight on our hands. Now this, yeah, I should check. Are these guys bothering the villagers? I don't think they are. They're still sleeping. Here's a zombie bothering me. And here's a spider. Spider come to give me its string. This spider might actually be like tame, because it is. I think it's. Is it almost fully light out? I think it's fully light. Yeah, the sun is. Okay, everybody's up and about. Okay. So now, yeah, we don't want to. I'm gonna hold the coins in my hand to signify my intention of trading. Not that I need to do that, but oh. The sun has risen where again? I always forget. In the east, kid. The sun rises in the east. Okay. Now, see, look, somebody's collected a bunch of cobblestone since we last went in here. Are you the person I trade with? Oh, no. Oh, you have a quest. You do not have the goods. Oh. Yeah, I don't have what I need for that. Okay. Okay, so the town needs iron. 3, 4, 5, 7, 8. Let's see what that does. 12 of 18, so let's do 6 more. 5, 6. Okay, so they have all the iron they need. Good. Yeah, I can't... I just sold them. I think I sold them all my cobble. I don't think that's what I wanted to do. If I double-click, yeah, that sells all my wood. But I want... I maybe earn a little bit more money. But yeah, I'll keep that, the rest of that cobblestone, because I need it. I needs it. Okay, I think that's enough trading for now, and I think this episode has gone on a little longer than they usually do. But yeah, look at these guys hard at work. I think it's going to be another episode before we see the next thing. Okay, so let's stand out here up front. Oh man, look at this village. It's just hopping, just crazy. To another. We will say goodbye to the listeners right now. Goodbye, listeners. Thank you for listening, listeners and viewers. thanks a lot for hanging out with me and watching another video of me playing the Millénaire game, and stay tuned. There will be another episode very soon. Also, you know, leave a rating and a comment. My favorite thing is the comment, so if you want to comment on the video, that would be really cool, because, hey, we could be friends or something. Anyways, that's it for now. Bye-bye.